Hi guys, this video is to review like two different power of the transmitter. This one is like 600 milliwatt, okay, and then this one is like 200 milliwatt. Okay, the difference is this one can transmit far away compared to the 200 milliwatt. Okay, so this one I think is like the 600 milliwatt is like they can transmit until like 400 meter to 600 meter. Okay, for like 200 milliwatt, right, they only can support like until like 100 meter to 300 meter. Okay, so you can see both are the same. They have like the power in here, and then ground, video, audio, and ground, and then DC for 5 volt out. Okay, so usually when you purchase, right, they will come together with the cables. So the cables here is like, okay, so they will have like the power in here, the red color one, and then the ground, the black one, and then the yellow is the video, and then the audio, and then the ground, the black one, and then the DC out to power up the camera, the FPV camera. So you can see this one is the camera here, and then yeah, they will have a connection and then connect to the transmitter. Okay, so we just connect it like this. Okay, and then another one you just connect to here, this side. Okay, once you done the connection, you just put into your antenna. Okay, so yeah, so you have done connection now, and then yeah, it's recommend you to put your heatsink because it's like they will very fast heat up. Okay, and then you just power up using this 2-cell battery, and then to power up your transmitter. Okay, so you can see like, let me demo to you. Okay, so let's say you have a 7-inch screen here. Okay, the screen here. Okay, and then the camera. So we will connect this, like just connect the power. Okay, so once you connect your power, they are turning on, and then yeah, when you turn on, right, actually they have they were blinking here. Okay, the channel. Okay, so you just turn on your FPV monitor. They will automatically detect from the transceiver. Okay, so you can see. Okay, so this is how the FPV transmitter and the receiver works. Okay, so let's say I just remove the power here. Okay, they disconnected, and then you just connect it back. Okay, and then you also can press something like search, auto search. Okay, then we'll auto search the signal again. Okay, so yeah, done. Okay, so for the detail, right, you also can refer to the data sheet. Okay, so next will be talk about the data sheet. Okay, so about the data sheet for EWRF and then the transmitter, FPV transmitter, the model is like TX5823, and then they have like version like 200 milliwatt and 600 milliwatt. So the difference is like for 200 milliwatt is like 100 meter to 300 meter, and then for 600 milliwatt version will be support until like 400 meter to 600 meter. Okay, so they have like 40 channel transmitter. Okay, support at like 5.8 gigahertz. So next, okay, so these are two different type. They will display here, 600 milliwatt and 200 milliwatt. So you can see like here will be like power in, ground, video, audio, and ground. Okay, they have two version, and then here will like the SMD digital display for the channel. Okay, and then the button here to change the channel and the band. Okay, so the connection is you just connect here to activate the transmitter. Okay, so this is a back view for the transmitter, and then here will be the front view. Okay, next you can see here like, yeah, they have mentioned like 5 socket, right? So it's like red, black, yellow, white, and black. Okay, so this is like for power in, ground, video, audio, and ground. And then so this is the product parameter, is like support 5.8 GHz, and then 40 channel you can change. And then why like 40 channel, right? Actually like channel 1 until channel 8, and then they have like the band, like frequency band is like A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so all this will display at the screen here. Okay, then you will know which channel you are, and then don't worry about the FPV for the receiver, they will automatically detect. Okay, and then the power supply, right, is required is like 7 to 24 volt. So like the 2-cell battery is supported because because the two cell battery is 7.4 until like 8.4. Okay, and then they have two type of power for the transmitter, and then the current is need is like 150 milliampere for 200 milliwatt version, and then 230 milliampere for 600 milliwatt version. Okay, and then the antenna is like reverse SMA jack, and then it's like just only like the weight only like 5 gram. Okay, so how to change the channel, right? So they have like the channel is like from 5645 to 5945 megahertz. Okay, so this is the guide. Okay, so you can just like step one, you can just like press and hold the button. Okay, the button behind here. Okay, at the backward. Okay, so you can change the band to A, B, C, D, E. Okay, just follow the data sheet here, A, B, C, D, E. And then you also can change the channel. To change the channel, you just press it again and then hold it. Okay, when the digital display, right, so you can see like 1 until 8, so you know which channel you are now. And then when which band, which channel, that means like which frequency, you also can key in manually in your receiver. Okay, let's say you have band A and then channel 3, there will be like 5825 megahertz. Next is like you can press and hold it, the VTS is back to the normal work state, and then the band and the channel frequency will display and turn on the display, the digital display. Okay, then you will know your channel and your band. Okay, for peak mode, right, what you need to know is like actually is the distance for transmitter only is about 2 to 3. Your receiver, right, can't detect if like far away from this distance. Okay, so you need to be careful about this. So to turn on or turn off, right, so it's just like press the button twice, okay, very fast, twice, and then they will have like red dot appear. Okay, the light appear at the right side bottom of the digital. Okay, that means it's turn off. Okay, so okay, right bottom digital display, that means the VTS have been turned off, that means they already turned on the peak mode. Okay, to turn on the peak mode, you just press the button twice, and then to turn off, when you see the red dot disappear, okay, at the right bottom, okay, that means the VTS is on. Okay, so everything is back to normal. Okay, so it's like 600 milliwatt, then you can transmit back for like until up to 400 to 600 meter. Okay, so just careful about the peak mode. Okay, so I think that's all for this. So when you purchase, right, they will give you the cables and the transmitter and the one antenna. Okay, so don't worry about the cable. This one, when you purchase the FPV camera, right, they will automatic together with the connection, like just now earlier that we show this. Okay, so you can see it's like together with this connect to the transmitter. Okay, and then this one is to the 2S power, and then this one is for the camera. Okay, so something like this, you will connect the camera and then to the transmitter and the power source. Okay, so yeah, that's all guys, so thank you very much.